Hi everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing the not that kind of first time book tag. I was tagged by Caffeinated Covers and I'm so excited to do it. I think this is gonna be fun. I haven't really thought back to the books I've read for the first time in a while. So the questions are not hard, but they're hard for me to like remember what my first was because there are so many. So I'm gonna start with the first bookish friend. My first friend that read so much, and honestly she probably read more than me starting out like in school. I did not enjoy reading. I'll take that back. I enjoyed reading for pleasure. I did not enjoy reading books for school. So there was a time I really didn't read that much because I was so sick of having to read books for school. But my friend Autumn read books all the time. She devoured them pretty much like I do, and we would sit and talk about books and what we were reading, what we wanted to read, what we enjoyed about this book, what we didn't enjoy about that book. And so yeah, I think Autumn was my first official like book friend, even though she was also just my best friend. The next question. The first book that I read for pleasure, like not for school. I don't actually remember the first book that I just read because I wanted to, but I'm gonna go with The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. The reason I'm going with this is because my sister-in-law got it for me for Christmas one year, and she's like, you're gonna love it. You like books, you like reading, this is gonna be your thing. And I didn't think I would agree with her, and then I started reading it, and I was like, oh yeah, this is definitely it. And once I finished it, I was so mad at her. I called her and I said, I cannot believe you made me read this book. I cried my eyes out. It was horrible, but it was so good. So this book, after a little while of not reading as much as I did, really got me out of a book slump. So I'm saying this is the first book I read for pleasure after a really hard semester in college. The next question is a book that you read that you knew was gonna, or that you knew was becoming a movie. Well, Twilight. Of course, everyone knew this book would be a movie. I want to say this book came out when I was in like middle school, and everyone I know was reading it. Even my cousin was reading it, and he is not that big of a reader. Actually, he gave me his last two copies of the series because he got through with it before I did. But I remember the night Twilight came out at Walmart. I was on my way to Florida with my mom and grandmother to go visit family. And when it hit midnight, I said, Mom, we have to go to Walmart. I have to get Twilight the movie. So I took my portable DVD player on this car ride with me. And as soon as it was midnight, we went to Walmart. I picked it out. She bought it. And I watched Twilight the rest of the trip to Florida. Like, I was devoted. I knew this book was becoming a movie and I was so excited about it. The next question is, first series that you finished all the way through. And this was a toss-up because I know a lot of you guys are gonna say obviously Harry Potter, but I grew up and still am in a very religious family, and so we did not read Harry Potter. My parents didn't really, not that they said no, but it was just kind of like a, oh, we don't read that here. So while most of you are gonna say Harry Potter, I'm going to say Chronicles of Narnia. And I know what you're thinking, Rachel, that doesn't make sense. There's witches and magic and whatever in this book too. Because C.S. Lewis is a Christian author, I think we all felt more comfortable with it. And there's also like the moral of Jesus being the lion that guides them and helping them find their way. And so I think we just took a really Christian approach to the Chronicles of Narnia series. And I loved this series. I still love it. Like, if you ask me what one of my favorite series is growing up, it's always going to be Narnia. I remember when the Scholastic Book Fair came to town and they had this book set. I've had this book set for years and I got it at the Scholastic Book Fair. But yeah, this is the first series that I remember finishing all the way. The next question is the first book that you read. I've read my whole life. My mom is an English professor at one point. Our house was always surrounded with bookshelves and books of every genre you could imagine. Any book you could imagine. So I grew up reading. Like, I remember when I was little having the book called The Little Red Hen, and it's about this little red hen who's making bread, and she asks all her friends, who's gonna help me make the bread? And everyone's like, no, we're not gonna help you. And then at the end, she makes her loaf and she's like, okay, who's gonna help me eat my bread? And everyone's like, yeah, I'm gonna help you eat the bread. And then she's like, no, you can't help me. You can't eat it. You didn't help me make it. So ha, in essence, that's what that book is about. But the first book that I remember reading, it's not really the first book. So the book that I chose for this question is The Circle Maker by Mark Batterson. I don't know why I really chose this book as the first book for this question, but it makes sense. I think this was like the first Christian book that I read, and I loved it, and I have since, you know, I have a whole religious section in my library. So the next two I don't have a book for, but I'm going to talk about them. I own the books, I just don't know where they are right now. So the next question is a character role model, and I'm going to say Eleanor from Eleanor and Park. And my reason is because Eleanor was unapologetically her. She was who she was, and you could take her or leave her. It was your decision, but she was not going to change herself, and I really admire that. I really admire someone who is going to stand to their goals and be who they want to be, and Eleanor, you know, she did that. That's who she was. The next question is author that I admire. This question is really hard for me because there are so many, and I'm not saying that as like a cop-out. I'm saying that as there are so many people or so many authors who really do a great job at their job and what they do. So I'm going to change this question a little bit. If I could meet an author and pick her mind, it is going to be the author. I'll put her name here. Daisy Jones and the Six. Are you surprised? No. Her mind, she is so detailed, and like every question you might have is answered, and you know it, and her books just have a great conclusion. And I think if I could sit down with her and have like a brainstorming session, I would want to do that. Like, she's definitely the person that I admire. I love her writing style. You feel so connected to the books automatically. I think she's great, and I really, really do admire her. Who was my first book crush? And I honestly don't know. I have racked my brain thinking about this. I honestly don't know. But right now I can tell you, I've been reading these series, the book Secret and Scone Society, and in that there is a character named Jed. He's a paramedic, and he is in love with one of our main leading ladies, Nora, and I love him. I think he's so sweet. I think he's honest, and he's doing an honest job, and he just wants everyone to be safe and happy, and I really admire that. I think he's really great. So he's my book crush right now. Next question is a classic book that you did not read for school. I think you guys underestimate how much an English major reads classics in college, so I had to really think about, okay, I've read this one, but I had to read them for class. So what is one that I read not for class? And I came up with The Amazing Adventures of Cavalier and Clay. Now, I didn't read this for class, but I have challenged myself to read every book off of the Rory Gilmore reading list. And it may not have been the first one off that list I chose, but it was one of the like first five books I read from her list. So yeah, this book I did not read for class. It is a classic. It's about these two cousins who want to start a newspaper, and it's all about, or no, not a newspaper, a comic, and it's all about their struggle of trying to start this comic book, and it's a lot. It's a pretty long, it's like 600 pages, but I really enjoyed it, and there were times I was like, I'm not going to like this book, but I really did enjoy it, and so that's the first one for that question. The next question was, first YA book that you read and enjoyed. Well, I have read a lot of YA in my day. I don't remember the first one. So I chose the first YA book that I read that I immediately had to run out and buy the second in the series of. And that is To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han. So this book I really enjoyed. I think Lara Jean is incredible. I think this book is so witty and funny and really well written. This was probably one of, if not the first YA that I immediately had to go buy, and I waited so impatiently for the rest of the books in this trilogy. So that is all for this book tag. If you enjoyed this video, make sure that you give it a like, comment, subscribe. You know the drill. This was fun trying to rethink and go back through my memories. It's harder than you think it is. A lot of the time I said, I don't think this is the first one, but I really tried. I gave it the best shot that I could, and I hope that you guys found this entertaining and informational about me, about my preferences. So if you have done this tag, I want to see it below. Make sure that you comment your video doing it, and I can't wait to see you guys soon with another video. Bye guys.